It's a new year and a new stage of the Basketball Champions League. Igokea hosting Belgian champions Philo Astende tonight in Bosnia-Herzegovina. This game one of a three-match play-in series. And it will be a battle there between these two in Laktashi. Igokea, they finished second in Group E of the regular season. Astende ending it third in Group F. Well, one game postponed. Place in Group K of the last 16 on the line for the winner of this play-in series. Both these sides had three wins and three defeats in the regular season group stage. Now trying to join the eight regular season group winners in the last 16. The double winners in Belgium last year and Belgian league winners in each of the past 10 seasons. Astende were last in BCL action in France on December 21st. The visitors winning 92 points to 91. At Strasbourg, an impressive win on the road for Dario Gerge's side. They needed a six-point victory, though, to get second in their group on the head-to-head record with Strasbourg. And the team in red on the road again as a result. Igokea winning 75 points to 64 at Pauk last week. This is the Astende lineup. They have a recent signing wearing number one, Demetrius Conger. Will add some height to a fairly tall side. Astende, one of the highest scoring teams in the competition. Levi Randolph, the number two, their leading point scorer with 16.8 per game, and history made last week as well. We got a shot of the back of her there. The assistant coach of Astende, Gail Buzan, took over from Georgia to lead Astende to victory against Strasbourg. Kokea, they have some big scorers in their ranks as well. Deshaun Stevens, 19 points and 9 rebounds he got in their last fixture. Good win over Park on the road. And that secured home court advantage in this play-in series. So two of the matches that will be played between these two sides over the next couple of weeks will be played at this venue, Laktashi Sports Hall, 20 kilometers north of Banja Luka in Bosnia-Herzegovina, about 3 hours northwest of Sarajevo. And the game's coming thick and fast in the Basketball Champions League from here on in. Three games tonight, two tomorrow, one on Thursday. Similar again next week. Well, Astende looking to get a big win on their travels here. They've had their problems coming into this match. Guard Phil Booth lost his international passport en route. Wasn't allowed to enter Croatia upon landing in Zagreb, unable to take the team bus to Bosnia-Herzegovina. They're hoping to fly back to Belgium the same day. He was in a race against time to make it. Kokea, no such problems for them with home court advantage. And they were in action on Sunday, actually, in the Adriatic League. 88-61 winners against Borac. Oostende have not played since their last BCL match on the 21st of December. Referees from Italy, Latvia and Turkey this evening. Oostende averaging 86 points per game in the BCL this season. And that's their starting five. Levi Randolph is a very important player for them. He got 23 points against Strasbourg in their last outing. Phil Booth got 30. Antonio Djurdjia is the Croatian in charge of Oostende. He's also the Belgium national coach. Nico Gea starting with Markel Starks in the point guard position. Starks with 10 points and 5 assists in that crucial win over Park. One of several Americans on the home side's roster. Marco Barat is on the bench again. He is assistant coach at Iko Gea, but Rakan Bajic unable to take his place for a second game running. The veteran in the Oostende ranks on camera was Dusan Djordjevic, 38 years of age now, number 20. Those three-point attempts dropping already. They have a whole series of sharpshooters, Oostende. Against Strasbourg in their last match, they were very good from distance. 10 from 20 they made. Conger, an interesting addition. The number one for Oostende. Look to see what impact he makes. Only joined the club on December 27th. 31-year-old from Brooklyn. Was with Pekim Spor earlier this season. Pekim, the Turkish side, and another Turkish side will be in action later this evening in a couple of hours. The champions, San Pablo Burgos of Spain, up against the Turkish visitors, Dirushafaka. Dijon against Riga, the other game in the BCL, which will be taking place in about 2 hours' time as well if you are watching this one live. All the games streamed on YouTube on the BCL official channel. Depending on where you're watching, you can tune in and catch up with the action. Here we go then, game one in the three-match play-in series between Iko Gea and Oostende. the Bosnia-Herzegovina side with home court advantage. They're in the white and blue strip today. Ostende, the Belgian champions, in red. And Phil Booth not named in the Ostende squad today, so that is a huge blow for them. The man who got 30 points, 8 assists and 4 steals against Strasbourg in their game day 6 victory in the regular season group stage. Up and running, Ostende. Good start from Olivier Trois-Fontaine. Well, that's a good three as well. Tabia Waller. Off on 10. A bit of a wild pass. Turnover for Ostende. And that wasn't great either. Starks a little lucky. Fast break chance wasted there by Ostende. Starks sending one up. For Fontaine. Support a little slow to arrive for him. Into the paint. Couple of weeks now since Ostende's last game. They will be a little bit rusty perhaps at the start. Mikko Geyer looking sharp. Georgievic, good pass. Bad finish. Starks laying it off, just not dropping for anyone at the moment. Ruslan Georgievic gets it to Trois-Fontaine, feeding it into Anis Bratanović. And this time, Ostende regain the lead. Seconds on the shot clock for Starks. Pick and roll. And floated home very nicely by Stefan Fundić. Trois-Fontaine goes wide. Slams back from Simon Poisson. Starks, great handling. Great finish. Markel Starks has an assist. And 2 points now. Okay, into the lead for the first time. Georgievic. Can't sink one. Good work. Under the glass by Bratanović. Bratanović is free. And he gets his second basket. Good feed by Boyce. All square again. Starks, lovely pass. Aggressive defending, effective defending. Fundić unable to score. Trois-Fontaine. Boyce. Bratanović, the go-to man. Third time unlucky for him. Starks on the drive, gets his basket. Great start from him. Leaving the court for now. We found that time on Sevas Beysat. Committed by Starks, trying to force the issue on that occasion. Three team fouls in this first quarter for Igokea. Starks averaging over 12 points per game in the BCL this season. It's a well-deserved break. Boysa, who has operated over on the right for much of this first quarter, has nailed the three, and Ostende go back in front. That's Adanov trying to find a way through. Kalic did well, and touched home in the end by Nikola Tanasković. Boysa leading it into Randall. Oh, look at that. Talic feels hard done by, but Levi Randall showing his class already. Madison, Alabama, 29 years of age now. His first season with Ostende. Has a chance to make this a three-point play. Does just that. Pushes the Belgians into a two-point lead. Randolph do similar at the other end. Tanasković giving Georgia a headache. Foul by Kai van der Verst on that occasion. The sides are level. Tanasković will have a chance to push Mikokea back in front. He's unable to do so. Randolph, they're moving it quickly now. Van der Verst, the floater is good. Delicate touch of the young Dutchman. Here comes the new man. New man on the floor. New man at Ostende. Demetrius Conger. Brooklyn, New York, wearing the number one jersey. Replaces Simon Boysa. Oh, wow. What a move. Finished off by Tanasković. Simple finish in reply. Van der Verst. Starks. Yeah. That's quite a way to announce yourself in the game. James Robinson hits the three. Randolph trading passes with Van der Burst. The jumper is good. Back. Take the 2 points. Randolph with defending to do on Milan Vulic, the number four. Here goes Robinson again. Sends it up for three once more. Came up short that time. Clock was against him. Stand up, leading by one in this first quarter. Looking to extend their advantage. Foul called against Belgian visitors that time. Deshart's not happy. Mikael Jantunen has been sent in, number 18 from Finland. Starks averaging 6.5 assists per game. Rick O'Gare. Robinson, another American, heavily involved at the moment as well, the number 8. Almost out of time. Unable to get a basket on that possession. Still very tight, but Kobanets will have been disappointed by that last attack. Dario Giorgia. Happy to see that Ikokea has gone over 5 fouls for the quarter. That's why Randolph was sent up the other end. 2 free throws for him. Misses the first. Three points for Randolph now. 4 minutes on court. Starks. A little bit complicated there, but Bosnians have it back again. Starks had to hurry. Up and under works out well. Tanaskovic. Looked like the chance was gone, but Nikola Tanaskovic doing some great work for the home side. 8 points for him. And there is a swift response. Conger getting his first points in the BCL for Ostenda. Puts them back in front. Conger then fouling Robinson. Starks is off for now. 4 points and 3 assists already for him. Side trail by 2, 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Tanaskovic, the number 10, lead scorer in the game, 8 points. Hasn't missed a shot. It's Robinson. Has to make this one, and he does! Oh, 2 seconds on the shot clock. Plenty of time for Robinson. Second 3-pointer of the game for Robinson puts Ikogea in front at the end of the first quarter. They were behind for long spells. Good signs for the home team. They managed to sneak ahead. We'll stay that way for the rest of the night. Yeah. Three pointers for them. Five turnovers in the first quarter for Ostende. Just one for the home team. Good plays to look back on. This was the first score of the game. Three-pointer from Olivier Trois-Fontaine. Waller responding straight away. Nick Okea. Number 16 chipping in with 4 points as Harris Vratanovic. Starks, one of the stars of the show so far. 4 points, a couple of rebounds, a steal, and those three assists as well. Levi Randolph doing damage. It's Vanaskovic, though. He has done the most harm to Ostende. 8 points and one rebound so far. That was brilliant. Starks picking out Vanaskovic. De Vries has 4 points as well. The number six for Ostende looks set to be another high-scoring match. A reminder, if you are just joining us, it is game one of a three-match play-in series in the Basketball Champions League. This one being played in Latashi, Bosnia-Herzegovina. Okay. Leading by one, they get us started in the second quarter. Waller got himself free and made it count. Good start. Waller, just like it was in quarter number one. Defensive foul in there. Vulic was the man who went down. Ostende have some issues. Robinson. On his game so far. Good pass out wide. Good work under the boards again. Robinson sends one up for three and makes it as well. 9 points for James Robinson. 7 point lead for Igokea. Surprisingly, Ostende calling a timeout.
They're scoring us only on the three-pointers because we are too low and the ball control we don't have twice. Hey, if they put the ball on a low post on him, hey, that's a two-man against our three. Hey, there's a 4-5. Must take here up higher. You get open. Trail, this is a shooter. They search and shooter for three-point shot. They get now 3-3 CZ here.
James Robinson is his second spell with the club. Looking very good so far. Three-pointers from four attempts.
Looking inside, find the weak side and read the back of the deck. Hey,
it's a two pin. Robinson from Maryland in the United States. Okay, his first club after graduating from Pittsburgh in 2016. Has played in Germany and Israel since then, returned in August. He's guarding Kai van der Verst. His pass finding Bratanović in the corner for three. Welcome three-pointer for Oostende. Jantunen got the three for Oostende. Missed by Waller, and he missed out on his defensive duties there. Didn't want to make a foul on Randolph. Randolph making it a five-point run for Oostende after their timeout. Waller overcooks that one. Great work from Tanasković. Robinson. Lots of foul in there. Waller hands it off for Robinson. Bounce pass doesn't get through to Fundage, but Diego Kea still have it. Robinson has to take this shot on. That's Conger. Demetrius Conger, beautifully done. Igokea's turn to call a timeout. The sides are level.
Let's go, Joshka Aleksan. Let's go, Stana Vola. Hey, first you skip open shot. Don't ever do that. Don't ever do that. Then you keep out to give you don't make it. Stane, ajde ne pomažemo. Don't overkill, no 3 points. Listen here. We go three.
Conger.
X-flex setting the screen.
Spinning away from the Waller there.
Marco, get the ball.
Former stay. Antwerp Giants player.
Funda. Stay, go out. Dribble handoff. Flare screen. Stay, first look is Marco. If you feel like they are switching slip, second look is Funda.
Ligo!
Decent crowd in. Holds 3,000. Just over. Maktashi Sports Hall. They've been provided with some very good entertainment so far. The number 24, Waller, missing his last couple of three-point attempts, though. He has made 2 from 5 so far. Here's Tay Waller. Starks back in. Waller. Pretty good shot from him, but the whistle had blown beforehand. He's got an explanation from the officials, but still looks a little confused. Van der Verst. Good take. It was Jantunen who held on that time. On the drive went Van der Verst. And a couple of calls going against Waller in the last minute or so. Van der Verst. Get us going again. Good vision, spots the free man. Randolph missing out. Step on the Oh, that was clever. Conger alerts. Back-to-back baskets for him. 6 points he's got now. Second foul sees Lundevorst withdrawn. The old wise head comes back in, Djordjevic. Two-point lead for the Belgians, and there's a steal. Conger on the move.
Waller
did really well. Now, well finished off on the fast break. Sides are level again. And a 9-point run without reply for Oostende comes to an end. Fundic with the layup. Here's the turnaround shot from Randolph. Good work by Conger. Djordjevic. Well overcooked. Djordjevic can slow it down. Randolph takes on responsibility. He has plenty of time here. Can't make the three. Starks waits for a couple of screens to be provided. Oh, that was very well taken. Tough shot. Six points for Starks. Gokea have a lead again. Randolph just a little too much on that one. He's trying to find Bratanović here, the 20-year-old is tall. Not that tall though. Bratanović, 6'10", number 16, hook shot good from Radanov. Randolph driving through traffic. Okay, another chance to extend their advantage. That would have been a very important basket. Randolph's done well to hold on here. Couldn't provide the finish, but fortunately for him, Trois-Fontaines is back on court. And the 32-year-old gets his first basket since the very first bucket of the game. That time, Radanov. Fontaine into Yantunen. 10 seconds on the shot clock for Oostende. Randolph will have to go alone here. Not ideal. And that one rattling out. Djordjevic. Fizz a pass through there, but the foot of Bratanović in the end. There's Darko Talic. Seeks out Starks once again. Oh, that's beautifully done. Elshilo with the handoff. Tomaskovic with the finish, and he's into double figures. Antonin turning one way and another, needs some help in the end, and gets it from Vlasanovic. Tanic sending up a three, gets a second chance, unable to take it. Key passage of the game, 2 minutes to go until the break. Backing in was Bratanovic. Georgievic, Trois-Fontaine. Wonderful. Ostenda lead. Side.
We are not fighting till the end, you know. We have good switch, we have good defense, and then you let your man alone. He takes the ball and makes a layup. We need to fight till the end, 24 seconds. Box out and grab the rebound. Two sides.
Trois-Fontaine sending Starks up. 100% record from three-point range for him. That's his second of the night.
Two-side regular. Mula, Alexa. Come out here, pass, handoff, Mula corner. Pick and roll, James Tane. James, Alexa. He's ready to defend. Pass to Alexa, Mula.
Oligo Kea have won their last two BCL games. They've yet to win three matches in a row in the Basketball Champions League, but hoping they will become a permanent fixture. Did very well last season. First campaign proper. To the playoffs. Georgievic somehow got a pass through there. Pierre-Antoine Gillet unable to finish, but he was fouled. Vulic in his second foul. Gillet, 30-year-old from the province of Liège, in his second spell with Ostenda. That's a couple of more points for them. Three. Good attempt from Radanov to try and pick up a rebound there. Yoshilo it was. And the shot from beyond the arc. Ostenda outscoring Igor Kea 18 points to 14 in this second quarter. And the arena is pretty quiet as a result. Georgievic at Ostenda since 2011. He's won 10 league titles. The Belgian club, he was Belgian league MVP a couple of times as well. He's on his 39th birthday now. Took his time on that attack and one worked out very well for last season's Belgian double winners. Stendet have not had too much luck in the BCL over the years. Finished third in their regular season group. Behind eventual champion San Pablo Burgos and Brindisi. So last season, this season, going better so far. Going very well on the road here, despite a foul by Torfontaine. Robinson. Good basket. 15 seconds left on the clock. The Oshilo brings Igokea back to within one. This is first basket of the game, Marco Yoshilo.
The ball to the Andrade. Okay, listen. Carefully. Dusan taking ball. Inbound there is Simon. Yep. You will play Simon like a four. Yep. This is pass to Oli. They have a right to give a foul. We go with the head. Okay, so listen now carefully. We pass, okay? Dusan screen for Simon. Simon cut to the corner.
Good finish
there. Get the balls. Slip
Yoshilo.
For a switch. Adapt.
It's up and
get
over.
It. 1-1.
Gillet.
You're at 1-1.
Hey. 2 points.
On the sideline. On the sideline, we go with the 2. Okay, we go with the 2.
Nice and calm tonight. Dario Cherche, the Ostende coach, he was ejected in the fourth quarter against Strasbourg back in December. A couple of technical fouls. Assistant Gail Buzan taking over, first female coach to get a BCL win. Georgievich in a hurry. Laskovic was with him all the way. No easy basket for Ostende to finish the second quarter. But, Georgievic, the man from Belgrade, he'll turn 39. On March 29th, he has two free throws now. Can't make the first. He's yet to score tonight so far. Didn't get that one either, but really good work. Torfontaine. Making sure that Ostende extend their lead. And the prayer sent up by Robinson not answered. So it's been very good work from the Belgian champions, Filou Ostende, in that first half. They lead by 3 in the end, scoring Igokea 20 points to 16 in the second quarter. And the visitors on top, just about an intriguing game one fixture in this play-in series in the Basketball Champions League. Some good three-point shooting from both sides. Torfontaine has 10 points for Ostende. Tanaskovic has 10 for the home side. Robinson chipping in with three triples. Golf and Vucanovic doing well for the Belgians as well. Coquelin, key player, and he got Oostende started with a three-pointer. Responding straight away was Waller. Six points. Starks. Very good. 6 points for him as well in the game. Three assists. Randolph, another American. He has 8 points so far. Nikola Tanaskovic has been brilliant. 10 points and three offensive rebounds. Robinson, pretty good. One behind the line. Randolph weighing in as well. Robinson, 3 from 6 he's got from 3-point range. 9 points and three assists for him in the first half. Waller, 2 of 5 in 3-point land. And a great 6-point run at the start of the second quarter did Ngukea. Did lead by 7 at that stage, 29-22, but Randolph helping Oostende come back into it, as did this man, the new signing, Conger. He's got 6 points and 3 rebounds, a steal as well. Fundic getting that basket, number 42 has 4 points so far. Starks, huge player for the team from Bosnia-Herzegovina. 7-time Bosnian champions. Ngukea, but trailing at the break in this one. Coquelin got his 3-pointer at the start of the game. Then he got 7 points in the second quarter. He has 4 rebounds. And he's having a very good night. He has yet to miss a shot, the number 89. Off the highlights with Yoshilo's first basket of the game. His side in a little bit of trouble. 39-42 at the break. Coquelin, this was the first shot, the first successful three-pointer of the match. He has got 2 from 2. 10 points from the field. Followed up very well too. Randolph missing that layup. Coquelin underneath the basket. 1 offensive rebound, 3 defensive rebounds as well. That was an excellent 3 late in the second quarter. A score that took Oostende into the lead, 38-37. They have stayed out in front to the veteran Belgian. Top scorer for Ngukea, their number 10. Tanaskovic has missed just 1 shot from 6 tonight. 24-year-old from Serbia, a summer signing. He's playing for RS Banja Luka in Bosnia-Herzegovina. 18 points per game in the second tier of the Adriatic League last season. So, 6'8", number 10 for the home team, going very well tonight. 3 offensive rebounds, 10 points so far. His side, though, trailing by 3 at halftime. Second half coming up very shortly.
Oh, sweet. Rim protection from Ronald Curry. Now Curry's gonna let it fly. What a sequence. Beşiktaş. Bounce pass. Oh, Adiyasi. Not in my house. And then Farrell. Count it. They get it back. Dreschel. He sees the opening and takes it. Anderson keeps it alive. Great work, Pienaar Kasiak. And now the baseball pass up the floor. And Embiid throws it down.
Falcao Sambaté have really put on a show tonight. And here's Golovin. How about that? Wow.
He's one of the most efficient three-point shooters here in the Basketball Champions League. It's a skill here. We got numbers in transition. Here's the match. Gets rejected. Well, bienvenidos a Burgos, but no in mi casa. You are not welcome.
Carter. Super. See you later. Left for dead here.
Still believe in their team tonight, making a nice atmosphere. Here's the alley. Are you kidding me? Anderson, what a play. Florence throws it up. And Anderson.
There's just a little bit of time. Beşiktaş launch it.
Oh, he made it. Arda, what a shot. Unbelievable!
And Ninu! Look at that celebration! That is super! Up and above, Abramaitis.
Well, it's just been a great game, and we're going to have a great finish. You can just feel it. They pass it into Lansdowne.
Wow, DeAndre Lansdowne.
Well, game one has been excellent so far in this play-in series between Igokea and Filos against the 22-time Belgian champions. And it is the Belgian side who lead. 42 points to 39, the score through two quarters. No Deshaun Stevens for the home team. And Bajic there as well, their head coach. Niko Bajic standing in, pacing anxiously of this third quarter. Okay, one win away from making the final eight of the BCL last season. Semi-finalists in the Adriatic League, lost 2-1 against champions Jelena Zvezda. We do have plenty of experience to draw on. That goes for Ostenda as well. Veteran guard Georgievich causing problems early on for Yoshilo. If you are just joining us, Ostenda in red. It's 23-22. 10 minutes. Ostenda finding back to lead by three at this stage. Here's Waller. Igokea through Starks getting the first basket of this third quarter. Randolph, Georgievich. To Van der Verst and into Bratanović. He did very well in that first half. He's done well here too. And able to add to his tally of 6 points. He has 7 rebounds as well. The number 16 was the number 30 looking to get a rebound. Gillet, who was fouled. 2 early fouls in this third quarter for the home team. Ostenda getting a basket through Boyce. No blocks in the game so far, and Randolph couldn't block Talic that time. Bratanović looking to draw contact, looking to get 2 points as well. Got neither, really. And that was quite the finish. Tanasković up to 12 points for the night. Georgievich, a pull-up jumper. Shooting not working out so far. Ostenda in this third quarter. Lovely pass through. Starks feeding Tanasković. Back-to-back baskets for the number 10. Six-point run. Igokea. Came off the foot of Yoshilo. Here comes Servas Beysart, 22-year-old Belgian, wearing number 14. Out goes Bratanović. Boyce, looking up at Georgievich. Voice to Djordjevic, into brought in from the bench, who draws a foul. Waller. Third foul of the night. I'll tell you, Waller. Boyce gets the three. Stender back on terms. Starks. Tanasković wonderfully well again. What a night he's having. 16 points now. Oh, he did everything right up until the last second. Levi Randolph to perform well for the remainder of this game if Oostende are going to win it. He was playing in New Zealand last season. 15 points a game there. Well, some concern for Georgia. Another turnover. There's a bit of bounds that time. Starks. And, not dropping. Gokea. Djordjevic. Ile in the left corner. Again, the attack breaks down.
Come back to him.
Well, 13 of this squad have been at Oostende for at least a year, so it's not a case of these players still getting to know each other. There's been a real breakdown for Oostende since the restart here. They've scored 10 points to 5. Georgia trying to work out what's wrong. Missing Phil Booth, of course. They're a 30-point scorer from last time against Strasbourg. He's averaged 17.7 points per game in his last three DCL games. Okay, though, missing one of their big scorers, Stevens, tonight. Waller can't get the three. Halic has a go. 5-point lead for the home team. Extend it, timeout. Third quarter for them. It's been a real struggle. Did lead by one at halftime against Strasbourg. Had a very bad third quarter that night.
Here on the pick, we dribble open line here so we can pass and then inside. If they help, weak side find for a shot. Hey, we have a zero fouls and we don't control the board at all. What they do to us now, they go with the four men in the pick and roll. And he changed angle at the last moment, and their fight is sealing. If it's necessary, we switch here.
Is,
he's attacking
good play.
Here, and we keep on the back,
okay,
and it's 1-on-1.
Okay, moving it quickly, talks. Waller. Hey, so Randolph coming to him. You. Talic was free outside him.
Here it's all the time now. Here it's all the time with Talic. Go with the zipper regular. Go one now. Where we will just wait to pass the ball to Pierre. We can try to play. Hey, as Bentley fouls, we have zero.
Nice reminder, sometimes needed by the coach there. The 46-year-old Croatian Dario Djordjevic. They haven't committed any fouls in this third quarter, so they can try and break up a few attacks. Stender needs to do better in possession though. Gile showing how it's done. Finish. The Oshilo, 29-year-old, restoring the 5-point advantage. Gile to Georgievich, round the back. Tidy from Weishart. First basket of the game for him. Starts slowing things down to look up at the clock. Had to take the shot on in the end, and that was an excellent finish into double figures for the night. Randolph got that one above Starks. And he goes into double digits as well. Americans trading blows. Turnover. Randolph stopped in his tracks. Quarter flying by. Okay, still out in front. And they have a chance of a 3-point play here. Starks and Tanasković linking up brilliantly once again. 18 points for Nikola Tanasković, drawing the foul from Gile. Points in the third quarter for Tanasković. A chance to make it 9 in this quarter, 19 on the night. Does just that. 6-point lead. Conger goes back. Difficult move that. Georgievich laid into the clock, then played a tricky pass. 12-10, losing his experience there. Second foul of the night. Urukea's momentum had to be stopped. Game 2 is next Wednesday, January 12th, in Ostend. Game 3 at this venue once again in Laktaši, Bosnia-Herzegovina, on January 19th. Followed by Gile this time. Ostender travelling 1,500 kilometres to get to Laktaši, home of Ugokea. Three-pointer. Free shot for Yoshilo. He makes it count. 7 points for him now on the night. 9-point lead, the biggest of the game, by some distance for the home team. Important rebounds, but no reward in the end for Ostender. Weishart, number 14, looking dejected as he made his way back into a defensive position. Robinson has it. Grigokea. They did call it. The visiting bench travelling. Radanov, the 23-year-old from Serbia. Ostend have won their last two away games in the BCL. They'd lost the previous six. Each of those two victories ending in margins of less than 3 points. Could be another tight one this evening, but the Belgians have a lot of ground to make up right now. Foul on Beysart that time by Fornic. Number six getting it to Gillet, but he's out under pressure, tipped away by Robinson. 23 points for Igokea in this third quarter, just 11 for Ostenda. That's the way it finished against Strasbourg in the third quarter. Crucially though, Ostenda, last fixture in the BCL, coming back to win that game, and they have a long way back now. Miosulo is really finding his range. Back-to-back three-pointers for him. Oh, that was big. That was vital. Kai van der Wurst with a very important three-pointer. To a 9-point game again. Into the final minute of the third, another free man here, and another three-pointer. It's that man, Yoshilo, again. Three in a row. Gile, maybe just two. It's a boost for Ostenda. Trailing by nine, 10 seconds to go. Robinson in possession. Big three attempted, that would have brought the house down. Time runs out for Stefan Fundic, but a very good third quarter from Igokea, and they lead by nine going into the final quarter. 20. Where did it all go wrong for the Belgians? Well, Okay, made 5 three-pointers from 16 attempts in the first half. He made 4 from 6 in the third. Tanasković, excellent again. He had 10 points at the halfway stage. He has 19 now. Not enough shots like that. The number four vice for Ostenda in the third quarter. Sharp shooting all round from Igokea. The bench coming to the fore. Three triples for Yoshilo, the number 16. Talic got one as well. He has 5 points. Starks, 10 points and 6 assists for the number 5. There have been some very good performances, but Yoshilo sealing the show late on in that third quarter. Three triples in a row. Of his points coming in the third quarter. Here we go then, final quarter. Game one of three in this play-in series in the Basketball Champions League. Igor Kea leading by nine. Alongside from Bosnia-Herzegovina, Stender from Belgium in trouble. First break goes their way in quite some time, really. Finished off by Tanaskovic, but we're not counting. Youngest player ever to start out for the Netherlands when he made his debut at 16 3 years ago. Vulic picks up his third foul of the game. Van der Burst with the pass in towards Conger. Van der Burst for three. Pass fired out to Gile, got the shot away quickly. No rebound this time for Ostender. No points on the board for either side in this final quarter as yet. Robinson. Radanov. Has to hurry. Oh, good pass. Control. Antonin did very well there to hold on. Van der Burst. There's another go. Air ball. Oh, it's worked out well. They get 2 points in the end. Had to work very hard for him. The Antonin, the 21-year-old from Finland, makes it a 7-point game. Robinson. Out of time. And some worrying signs now for Igor Kea. Starks has been on court for 22 minutes. 10 points, 3 rebounds, 6 assists for the number 5. One of the key players for Igor Kea. That great 11-point win over Park on December 29th to get home court advantage in this play-in series. These sides hoping to make the last 16 of the BCL this season. Unable to come away with any points there. Robinson draws the foul. Conger. Did wrong there. Looks a good addition because Dimitrios Conger just arrived in the last few days, played in Australia with the Adelaide 36ers. Played all over, really. Israel. US, Spain, France. It's Robinson at the line, though. He's had a good night. Hasn't scored for a while. It's that one. 10 points for James Robinson now to go with 6 assists. 8-point game.
Listen. Hey. Read on who he starts. Okay? Read on who he starts. Go first with the away game. Whichever side is the man where is the stars, 2 or 3 men. Okay, and we go on a pick and roll. If they go on the switches. On both screens, space it, pass, then read high low, find the weak side, read attack of the catch, you try to steal on your man.
You say side of Starks, right? Oh, no.
Opposite of Starks. We want Starks in a pick and roll.
The air ball
Starks
from
or
Robinson,
you understand? Because right now we have a guy
brilliantly to keep it in, got it to Jansen. That's the only score for Ostenda, but
yes, for the guy
an important
starts.
One.
Hey, guys,
get them
guys.
Going.
Listen,
get them eating into the home side's lead in this final quarter.
Hey, come on, hey, come on, Ray, let's go, let's go.
Long journey. Travel 16 hours by car through Germany, Austria, and Slovenia to get to Laktaši in Bosnia-Herzegovina from Ostenda. Easier to take a 2-hour flight from Brussels to Banja Luka. Flying out tonight, Ostenda will be flying out, trailing in this series by game to nil. Jantunen. Get 2 points there. 6'8". He certainly had the height advantage over Starks on that occasion, but couldn't make it count. Here is Starks. Formerly of Georgetown. Washington, D.C. This is first European experience. Pretty good so far. Jantunen frustrated by that call. A man from Helsinki, also playing in Europe for the first time as a pro. Fundic. Fundic. Second shot, in which the 27-year-old Serbian, has been with care for a couple of years, and increased the advantage by one. Randolph helping to reduce it. Vandeverst with the tee to Randolph. Doing really well. Fouled in the process. Hey. 12 points so far for Levi Randolph. Make that 13 and make it a 6-point game. Much better in this final quarter, Ostenda. And they can sense that they're getting back into this game in a big way. Foul by Fundic on Randolph. Randolph has a previous BCL experience with Avellino, Sassari, and Strasbourg. 23 points against his former team last time out. The number two has a big role to play here. He is taking on Tanasković. A little unfortunate there. And, can't get the steal at the end of all that either. Low scoring this final quarter. Stender have 5 points. Gokea 2 points. Waller back in for them. Starks calling the shots for now. Wriggling through, takes on a difficult shot and makes it. And the burst away from Waller. Foul by Waller. That's quite a few in the game tonight. That's number four against his name. Van der Wurst spotted the mismatch there. Jantanen, the big man, being marked by Waller. The worst, unable to get his sixth assist of the night, but he did create that opportunity. Jantanen fouled. Jantanen making both of his foul shots. Four points for him in this final quarter, 6 points between the sides again. Here goes Starks on the drive. Tanasković couldn't hold on. Be a big moment. Eagle-eyed Italian official. Okay, averaging 76 points per game. That time, his second basket. Useful time. Five fouls already for Igokea, though. They are one of the most physical sides in the BCL. That will give Ostenda some hope. Any fouls from here on in? I mean, free throw chances. 11 seconds on the shot clock. 5 minutes to go. Randolph with the jumper. Starks shows Randolph how it's done. Four points without reply for the Bosnians. Jantanen under real pressure. And Starks will slow it down. 14 points. Six assists. Is he going to take on Georgievich? He has to in the end. Georgievich, he had a foul to give up there. Four team fouls now for Ostenda. Tries again, pulls up. They're all dropping for him at the moment. 8 of 11 from the field for Markel Starks. Extender timeout. They're down by 12. The situation is critical.
We need to pass the ball faster and look at the axe of the catch. You need to seal on your man, and if they crowd it with the weak side, we need to open passing line for a pass for a shot. Okay, here now. Oli, you taking Starks. Starks, you taking the other one, you stay with this Radano. Hey, onside curl.
Starks.
But
showing his class here.
On a curl.
Back-to-back baskets.
We go on the side of the Starks.
It could be crucial ones. Laskovic did really well there on Jantunen as well.
Okay. So curl, go with DHO, space it, and with him switch inside that, right?
Starks, the 30-year-old from Maryland, averaged double digits points-wise in his 2 years in Russia with Saratov before moving to Igokea in the summer of 2021. Could be the difference tonight. Him and the number 10, Tanaskovic. Points without reply for Igokea, and they'll have a chance to extend that run. Eight rebounds for Yoshilo. Starks is in the zone here. Robinson. He was fouled. Georgievich again. That could be costly. Middle collision. Robinson. This is the first though. Played with many. Reuth and Braunschweig in Germany on the 2013 under-19 World Championship with the USA. He's getting a little tight here. Three free throws for Robinson. He's missed two. Makes the third, and that could be all that's required, really. Still just about enough time, though, for Ostenda to come back in this one. 13 points down. Randolph could be the man. Calling for some movement. Georgievich blocked. Great work again by Starks. 3-on-2 break. Oh, everything is working out. Radanov finishing that one off. Point game. What a defensive effort this has been. What a block again, Tanaskovic. That's his third of the night. Randolph coming through, Tanaskovic saying no way. Look how high he got up. Starks. Yoshilo. Tanaskovic is there again. This time he loses out. Conger. 15 points between the sides. Just over 2 minutes to play. Stend have managed only 24 points in the second half. There's another block. I think it was Josilo that time. Robinson. Foul. Called against Bratanović. Mananoff has done some good work in this final quarter. 6 points for him. Has an assist and a couple of rebounds as well. Slipping away from Ostenda. They led 77-64 early in the fourth against Strasbourg. The French side going on a 19-2 run. And Kea managed to build up some real momentum in this final frame as well. Radunov getting a couple more points. Called against Kanaskevich this time. Former Partizan player, younger brother Dusan, also a pro with Partizan. He has been sensational. Randolph at the line. Remember, there's no Deshaun Stevens, the 32-year-old from Los Angeles, for Hugo Kea this evening. He's normally the big man doing all the damage. Laskovic, naval deputy. Robinson. Excellent again. Too much at this stage. Game one is definitely going to go the way of Hugo Kea. Randolph getting plenty of free throw practice right now. Superb second half display, and what a performance from that man. 21 points for Nikola Tanasković. Tanasković did well on a disappointing night. Points for him. We've not seen too much of the number 16 in the second half. Hugo Kea take game one in the play-in series. Dario Gergia accepts defeat. His side well beaten Superb second half performance from the home side in Laktashi. Comfortably outscoring Ostenda and winning by 15 in the end, having trailed by 3 at the halfway stage. 87-72. So, Igor Gea take a one-game lead in this three-game series. All smiles for the home team. And they all played their parts. They have to travel to Belgium next week. That won't be easy. Their away record not great in the BCL. Ostenda have been playing without fans in Belgium for the last while due to COVID restrictions, but it was looking good for the Belgian champions at the halfway stage. Quarter three though, Nico Gea outscoring Ostenda 29-17. They led by 9. Side might have been worried when Ostenda got it back to 70-64 in the fourth, but again, Igor Gea outscoring Ostenda by 6, 19 points to 13 in that final quarter. And worthy winners in the end. Well, most of the best plays will involved, Igor Gea players, chief amongst them. Michael Starks, the number 5, Nikola Tanasevic, the number 10. The two best players on the night, along with Marco Josilo. The Ostenda attack really losing its way. Boyce got a 3, he finished with 8 points. Starks. Brilliant finish under pressure. Michael Starks, 16 points on the night. He only missed 3 of his 11 shots. He had 4 rebounds, 7 assists. Even had a block in there as well. Josilo really came to the fore, turned the game in the third quarter. 3 three-pointers late in the third. The number 16 had 13 points in the end. 8 rebounds as well, an assist and a steal. And from range, he was lethal in the key stage of this first game. Gillet, he ended with 7 points. Levi Randolph, the leading scorer for Ostenda at 17. Jantunen got that last basket, he had 7, that was Randolph. 7 free throws for him. Missed 10 of his shots, though, by Randolph from the field. Aranov did well, especially in the final quarter, ended up with 8 points. Tanasevic, though, what a performance at both ends of the floor. Starks, consistent. Tanasevic, sensational. 21 points. That was block number 3 of the night for the big number 10 from Serbia. That was the block from Starks. Radanov finishing this one off. Tanasevic, the figures, brilliant for him. That was another of his blocks. 21 points. 6 rebounds. 5 offensive rebounds. 1 steal, 3 blocks. Brilliant second half from the Bosnians. Robinson finishing with 13 points. Tanasevic, though, will take the plaudits along with Josilo and Starks. 21 points for Tanasevic, 16 for Starks. Josilo and Robinson getting 13. And a great night for Igor Gea. 87-72, they won this one, game one. Game two to come next week. Plenty more on the way this week in the BCL. With me, Mark Rodden, it's goodbye for now.